Having a prize for the handsomest guy. Who is that handsome guy? Who are these two guys? Let's cover them up. Look at that good-looking guy. Holy mackerel. Hard to believe a man could be that handsome and be this ignorant. Oh, the rain has totally gone away. It looks like we're even getting a little peek of sunshine here.
Yes. Thank you.
Okay, so what it boils down to here? Who's the lead dog here in the race?
I think that would be Howard.
That's Howard? We gotta figure some way of screwing him up.
He did pretty good, I know.
Yeah, you fly the plane and we'll be impressed. That thing is a horse, boy.
That's a world class airplane.
The Shark?
No, that's just a Starbot airplane. You got a world class.
Yeah, you got one made in China. That's
that would be world class. Do we know if Ping Pong made it?
Nah, do they make anything? They have guys that make it, right? Slaves or something. Guys in jail. Guys that get caught shoplifting. Mm-hmm. Or ex-Boeing employees.
Guys that criminals, they park them out. They do.
They sent them to America to be made.
Yeah, they fired them out. Need a new kidney? Need a liver?
PA.
I didn't get a chance to watch you fly, though.
Huh?
Did you just finish flying?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's nicely finished. Is that automotive paint or?
Yeah, automotive.
Automotive, okay. Acrylic?
Acrylic.
That's very nice. Nice airbrush. You copied that from?
Yeah.
That's
with
nice.
Aerographo.
Right, okay.
Aerographo, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Very good.
But next time you'll be a PA 75.
Very good.
Because PA 75 might take you to the world lead.
Yes.
To the championship, right?
So, well, it took him to the championship.
It worked. That's what I mean.
So?
I mean, on his step.
And he has to pay Randy now all that residual money off of the...
No, I get a cut.
You get a cut?
Yeah, there, yeah.
Email me and I will tell you whatever you need to know.
Beautiful. Great. I will
no
do
problem.
That.
Okay.
Well, the clouds are almost totally gone and it's turned out to be a hot sunny day. I'm going to run over and get some sunscreen. The ladies are out at the restaurant as we speak right now. They're having their lunch and we're going to have round two of the contest. I think Howard's in the lead right now, but I'm not sure. He was in the lead before. There's a real man, barehanded rota, barehanded carbon prop.
Oh, vai começar a live, foi isso aqui, tá?
The only guy here knows what a motor run is. Now, when you have that, you make the propeller. You want to go faster, more pitch, slower, less pitch, but you don't touch the needle valve.
Okay.
Once it, it's perfect. Perfect.
Ele falou que a regulagem da agulha é correta quando você faz isso, que você sobe e não acelera quando você vira.
See this? What I do with this? See the gray car? Put it under the tire and drive over it. Now, do it with this ear.
Yes.
When you know that sound, like, that's music.
Yes.
That's music. Everything else is nonsense.
Symphony.
Symphony, right.
Ah, eu dá bola pra esse bolo aí, pá!
This is Stalker.
Oh, it's Stalker. Okay, and this is, how big is this hole?
Ah, okay, it's...
Deflector.
Qual tamanho?
Deflector? How big?
Size?
How big?
How big? No, no.
How big? David, how big is the exhaust on a...
Me dá tua trena.
On a Stalker, is a Stalker muffler? That looks too small to me.
It's a 60?
60.
That should be okay.
Be okay?
It looks to me small. My number, this number here is... No, that you can't tell. You have a micrometer. Yet, this is 400 thousandths, 4/10.
9 millimeters.
How much is, I don't know, millimeters. That's
nine.
Could be from Mars, I don't know.
Looks like about 3/8.
That looks like 375 if it's 3/8. Might be hot, watch it. Do it again, touch it again.
Fudeu.
Falou pra você dar uma afinada no escapamento.
How big is the prop? Is it over prop? That looks like a pretty big prop.
Here's the sound.
Yeah, no, I heard it.
And it sounds close to being overloaded, not overload. Yeah. I'm trying to explain to him, don't go faster with the needle. Pitch your prop up, pitch your prop down.
Right. Yeah.
Get that in that motor run where it's happy if you're going to run it that way with a muffler. If you have a pipe, you could do more choices, but. Is that an under camber?
No, it's flat.
It's a flat?
It's a classic overloaded under camber sound. But it's not.
Yeah, exactly.
I'd say cut an eighth off of each tip of the prop.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the easy solution. You're going to start smucking with other stuff right now.
Well, you can't change the hole here.
No.
But the worst thing you could do is put that rubber thing on the end of that. And then make sure you put the one for a 40, not a 60. That really makes it better.
So did he pull off the rubber tip? Or?
No, I don't know. I don't know. I just heard it run.
Tem que haver uma borracha aqui para o calor não ir pro tanque. Não é borracha. Tem que ter uma separação porque o calor vai pro tanque e aquece o combustível.
É isso que estava conversando hoje. Is too much engine?
No.
No.
Good. Good. Very good.
Russian.
He asking about the heating, the tank. Like put some wood or something to not.
Tin foil. Tin foil or asbestos, if you have asbestos. Tin foil.
But here we don't have this.
Aluminum?
Sure. Do you have normal aluminum?
We don't have this grocery kind of store.
Get the grocery store. Yeah.
Tin foil.
Yes.
And papel aluminio.
Yes.
Sure. Okay.
But put around the tank or?
They probably have some over by the food store. They open up hot dogs or something.
Just put around.
Yeah.
Mazzarino, passa papel alumínio.
Just rubber band. Just rubber band, hold it on. But I don't think that's it.
See, an order on the board.
It's over here on the...
On the end of the trailer? Oh, okay, I'll look. They run the pits nicely like this. Very good.
Nossa senhora, depois de uma dessa, né? Do braço. Se você cair daí, você não vai quebrar o braço.
Não vai ter coma nenhuma.
Tá roubando a mão.
Eu pego do chão, tá limpinho, ó.
Caiu
lá. Por que eu falei que eu vou tomar
chuva
de amor? Mas eles fazem na mania de catar nozes. Eles põem um negócio no tronco e chacoalham a árvore. E deitam em cima de lençol. Vai, Pink! Vinde a nós! Passa bastante cagada! Olha quanta mora que ela pegou! Brincadão!
Fica sem.
Não só o tamanho dessa, só minha.
Shhh. Ou pôr a mão lá na frente. Shhh,
calma a boca.
Thank you.
Okay, the footage just before this, I think Thomas Case Jr. had my camera downwind and tried to get some of that terrible flight. We really are not able to get enough nose weight in the plane to keep it running steady, and but we're trying. But Howard's still leading the pack big time. Now, we want to see Thomas Case Jr.'s flight. I'm going to get that. Then I'm going to go take 2 feet off the lines. See if that'll help a little bit. We're struggling, but it's a little breezy now. This is nice. You can use the obelisk here for your intersections. Afternoon, about halfway through the round, it's starting to get a little breezy. It's really warmed up. It's not warm now. It's outright hot. We're all greased up with sunscreen, so. These sharks are really flying well down here. I'm not sure who has the best one, but they all fly well. And they have a real nice motor run. It's getting a little turbulence there. Whoa, low bottom, baby. Yeah, a little bit of breeze out there now. Looks like it's blowing right at the obelisk, too. Yep, right up the obelisk. Benet's been coaching him for quite a while now, so it's pretty obvious the improvement we see. Good save, baby. Good save. Good save! Woo! Well, we just had a little accident behind us. Somebody, you know, we go over and take a look at it. It looks pretty bad. Good save, kid! Thomas Case Jr. Yeah, we had the accident right at the end of Thomas's flight. Thomas Jr.'s flight. I'm not sure what it... Yeah, it looks pretty bad. You couldn't tell. Somebody nosed one in. There's one over here that lost a nose before. I don't think that was bad, though. Oh!
No, bundão, você já voou.
Come on, we want to see you fly.
You know how you say in America, don't be a baby. Don't be a baby. We got like the Sao Paulo marching band across the street here. Model trains, boats in the pond. Turned out to be a beautiful sunny day. This is to save money on an electric starter. We just flip it fast forever. All right.
Qual é o nome?
Yep, something's waiting for something. What a day. Now Thomas tells me that the way they run the contest here, they're going to take the top 18 for the fly-off tomorrow. We don't know where we stand. We haven't looked at the scoreboard yet, but Howard was the winner so far. So we'll see, but they add the scores together and who knows at the end how it could turn out. Okay, I guess Benet's going to give him a hand. Yeah, they usually start better inverted anyway. Open it up, baby, open it up. Doesn't look like much damage. Oh, you're up. Listen, and don't pull that old fake, the prop is loose thing. I'll take an attempt. The air's not getting better. Get this over with. All right, so Dave's up next. We're going to get downwind.
I see the fuel starter and that.
Where's your guy out there?
No fuel.
Wow.
Two out, bottom of the ninth. Red Sox are on first base. Midgley's on second. Just waiting for Dave Fitzgerald to get pitted up. Pretty bumpy. Okay, Dave Fitzgerald, second official on Saturday. I got both of your son's flights, even that great save he made. Uh-oh, pigeon. I saw the little parrots fly over before. He got a little hit there. He wasn't expecting. He's doing the back run on the hourglass. Good move. Really need it too. All right. All right. You're through the hard part now.
What's the problem?
Good. Man, that's the sound you don't want to hear with a four-stroke.
Burp, burp, burp.
Ooh, nice landing.
Whoa!
Whoa! Woo!
Beautiful flight.
Too bad you left out the triangles. What a shame. You could have beat Howard. Dave had quite a nice flight. This is Raul flying the Strega with an Enya 61. He said it's relatively new and he's got to work on getting some props. The one goes too fast, one goes too slow. Right now, put the fast one on if you have a choice. It's an ARC Strega. This to me looks like it. First thing I would do is tape the hinge lines, tape the hinge lines. Whoa, getting some breeze there, baby. I just felt it over my shoulder.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
Whoa, that was close. Okay, he caught through it. Whoa.
Boy, am I glad that's over. Oh my gosh. Woo! I'm ready for a soda. Help, help.
Okay, the master, Bene Rodriguez. He, by the way, Thomas has told us on the way in here that Bene takes care of manicuring the field and cutting the grass and of course coaching his son, among other things. And of course he is a world-class flyer, no doubt about it. He flew very well at Rodex this year, very well.
Good.
He's doing great. I hate to say this, but I think he's beating Howard.
Oh, that's just fine. Howard needs some humility.
Yes,
sometimes.
Yes. Now he's flying. This is a great flight. Considering, and he's on the crappy circle here too.
Yes, he is.
You had a good flight. There was one glitch in there somewhere.
He's not giving up the Cloverleaf when it quit.
Nope. There was one of your maneuvers we were all a little nervous about, but
oh, the vertical. The vertical.
Oh, somewhere in there.
About 10 feet in the
Yeah.
Inside.
Yeah, I knew that wasn't a handle input.
I can hear everybody say, whoo, whoo.
Yeah. Thomas Case was thinking, I wonder what he'll give me for this plane after I crash it. All right. This is a good flight. This is the best flight I've seen today, except for yours. So.
Nice comeback. Actually, that's a very good flight, period.
I don't know. I didn't see it from downwind, but you and him look like the top runners now. Grease it in, baby. Grease it in. Grease it in. On the main. Oh! Woo! Hey! Whoa! Show off! Nobody get his plane. Nobody get his plane. What a show off!
Go back to the United States.
Looking like he might be the front runner now. One of these two guys will be the front runner. I don't know. So day one qualifying is over. As you're all over looking at the scores, the top 18 will fly tomorrow.
Okay.
Now pay attention. This is pretty cool, Fitzgerald.
Yeah. 12 volt.
Yeah. So right there.
Yes. Yeah. Here you, I choose the
target.
The target. Yes.
So minus 273.
This is centigrade.
Yeah, minus 273.
Yeah.
That's a Peltier effect device.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Here the internal.
And comes out.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now you have a choice. You can keep your fuel cool or your beer. So far, nobody's ever put fuel in the cooler yet. Yeah, it's all insulated.
A few minutes.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
It's already getting cool. Yeah.
So you got a heat sink on one side and a heat sink on the other side.
Huh? Yeah.
Very good.
That's cool. Yeah.
This is going to take some of the variability out of.
Yeah, I'm going to do
it. What really takes the variability out is you take the four-stroke out of the plane and put a two-stroke in.
I started to do an experiment. It's not finished, but I can see how fuel viscosity varies from temperature.
And they did it. What
temperature? The viscosidade.
Okay. Combustível.
Varia com a temperatura.
So St. Thomas the result.
Well, no, you're going to have to put it in Sutner's and do different percentages of castor versus synthetic clots versus other stuff. You're going to have to make this
kind of
a scientific paper.
I kind of agree with you, Randy, about
the scientific paper.
I'll tell you, that P-47 with a Rojet 90, you'd be celebrating me and Fitzgerald kicking each other around the parking lot. He may still win, but I'd give him more of a shot.
With a Rojet 90.
Well, what's better, Rojet 90 or 12 ounces of brass and a four-stroke?
It's a dog. This is a dog park right here, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, look, the bone. It's shaped like a bone.
Watch, there's a dog right here. He looks like he's sleeping.
There's also a dog toilet. Yeah.
Don't run me over. I'm a good doggy. Hey.
Ciao, ciao, amigo.
It's like a flea market thing here. Oh, they got food.
Ooh, yeah. They have events in here.
Oh, wow. Hot dogs. Pretzels.
Is that legally done, or are these like outlaws that just park there?
I don't know.
In New York, they're not legal. They don't have no license or anything. This guy here, he doesn't have a permit to fix cars, does he? He knows I'm taking his picture. You see that?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. See that? He's a gangster.
Look at that Rolls.
Yeah.
Boy, we got everything here. We got a real Rolls, a left-hand drive, and a guy on his knees fixing bicycles. Wow, some of everything.
On the street where your hotel is.
Amazing.
I used to have a bunch of office. I still have a bunch of office. But about 20 years ago, I used to do a lot of promoting of international seminars through a direct mail.
Mm-hmm.
And I used to have to make 2-3 million brochures a month.
Oh my gosh, wow.
And I built a printing shop right in the middle of the city.
Mm-hmm.
I that street there with no permits.
No permits. Oh.
Put up a wall so you couldn't see what was behind the wall.
Uh-huh.
And the print shop there used to run 24 hours a day, 6 days a week.
Mm-hmm. I'm liking Brazil no more and more.
Situation for the guides.
So, did
how
you?
Was the day?
Karen swears she didn't buy anything. So,
you know what I used this jacket for? I got wet, and this was over the airplane. I left the raincoat here in the hotel room.
I know.
Did you use it?
Was everything nice today?
Brush yours.
I don't see anybody complaining, you notice?
So, we are going to the municipal market.
Tomorrow.
Today.
Oh, today.
Today was very impressive.
Ooh, I've never seen Karen come home empty-handed. This is a first.
Really?
She usually comes home with a big shopping bag that she tries to hide, and then she kind of fesses up to it. Oh, honey, don't you want something good for supper? Oh, I bought a little stuff at this market there. You can tell things are not exactly the same in Brazil. Look at this sign. Warning, before getting in, make sure the lifts are in the floor.
Yeah.
Can you imagine?
I didn't know that.
I looked, Howard saw it. We looked at the sign. Pretty funny.
Is it in English?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't see the English. I was reading the
English. And with that behind us, time to get ready for dinner. Is this a typical Brazilian sports bar here? Everybody's getting rowdy. When their team doesn't lose, they jump up and down and throw beer at each other. Boy, this is nice. Everything's out on the street here. Look at this.
The black dog.
Karen, check this out. Look at this. Isn't this nice?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The black dog. You didn't bring my camera, did you?
No. You told me you're going to bring it.
I was going to go back upstairs, but...
Amazing.
Young Thomas told us that
I didn't go back upstairs.
I hope that doesn't mean they make horse meats on the menu.
I don't know.
Ooh. Hooves for sale.
You'll never know.
Hooves for sale.
Fine.
Tastes like chicken.
Tastes like chicken with a horseshoe on it. Look who's there! I got them on it! Who's there? Look who's there! Look at his one trick pony, one trophy, and he's a tired boy. Look at this. Oh my God. Is that what a horse looks like before they chop him up? Look at this food. Oh my God, this is another one of these.
That's over, all I have here, that and fish.
Overeating special. Horse and fish.
Horse and fish.
Okay. That's some spigot. Look at that. Look at how this rotates.
Yeah.
Wow. All right, so we're going to the Hassan Pfeffer. Oh, there's a menu. Look at the menu. When you translate that, it says, don't worry, we don't eat horses. This is the Brazilian stunt barbecue. At a Brazilian barbecue. That's what I thought that was. When you, I was telling Mrs. Fitzgerald here how sophisticated we were. Not really. He's tired. He's tired. Oh, look at this guy.
Did you wear him out today?
We wore him out like a pencil eraser.
I've never heard that before.
He started off real strong, but at the end of the race, oh my, he had rubber legs.
Thomas, why so tired? Too late last night?
He's not a fourth quarter guy.
I guess guess not.
He better run up the score in the morning because he's not going to do it in the afternoon. Oh!
Okay. Fly.
Learning to fly.
Argentina.
A bottle of wine.
Malbec.
And they look, they got Yashchenko sharks on the stamp here.
Yep. Turn around and see what happens. Just the.
Isn't that cool?
All right. Yep, in the spice room.
Oh yeah.
Pessoal, vamos sentar. Fala assim. Você, por favor.
A palavra.
Vou falar.
Muito boa noite.
Boa noite.
É um grande prazer estar aqui com vocês hoje de noite, que eu tive o privilégio de participar do campeonato mundial em Londres, França. E naquele campeonato houve um campeão mundial. E eu resolvi que eu queria que vocês aprenderam a voar com ele. Eu convidei ele e o resto do equipe americano e também do equipe argentino para vir para o Brasil, para que vocês poderiam confraternizar com eles. E por isso nós fizemos esse campeonato hoje. Então eu gostaria de apresentar primeiramente o campeão mundial de F2B, David Fitzgerald.
Yeah.
David?
Hey!
I would like to say what an honor it is to have Thomas invite us down to your party. And say thank you very much to everybody for having a wonderful time. Thank you, Thomas. Thank you very much.
Thank you, David, for coming.
Yay!
Now, tem uma pessoa que é famoso nos Estados Unidos porque foi 18 vezes quinto. Campeonato Nacional dos Estados Unidos. Então, como especial visita nossa, eu convidei
Lindy
Ortonowski.
Hey, world famous! Hey! 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 Take the wine! Hey! Very famous, hey!
18 times fifth place.
Oh, 19.
He's a naughty baby. He's a lugar nos Estados Unidos.
Hey.
E também veio o assistant team manager dos Estados Unidos, que foi uma vez, campeão de combate. Mundial.
Combate!
Este ano fiz com o Lindy Ortonowski quinto lugar. Howard Rush.
Yeah. Hey!
Now, esta festa é para aprender a voar. E quando eu estava em Rafaela, argentino este ano, nosso colega Elísio infelizmente não podia estar aqui hoje, me apresentou uma garrafa de vinho que eu achei fabuloso. Learning to fly.
Hey!
Aprendendo a voar em espanhol. E eu resolvi que o vinho é muito bom. Então eu encomendei 24 garrafas para nós tomar hoje, hoje, com nossos convidados e aprendemos a voar. Learning to fly with them. So I ask you to join me. I ask you to para você. Viva!
Viva!
Uma capa dessa, uma capa completa.
E acredito.
Aqui, ó.
Acredito que o vinho é bom também. Não é só o nome. Mas pouco, pouco, porque o campeão mundial.
Bem atrás.
Bem atrás. David Fitzgerald, segundo lugar! Com avião chinês! Com avião chinês! Em terceiro lugar! Foi magro! Ele está aqui?
Aqui!
Tive coragem para terminar a gama. Em quarto lugar foi Wind.
Tell them in Portugal I'm taking bets on I'll be fifth tomorrow. 18-1 is the odds.
In quarto lugar foi Howard Rush.
Yeah.
Hey!
Quinto lugar, quem foi?
Windy.
Windy.
No, no.
Ah! Sempre ou de sempre. Windy Rubenhauser em quinto lugar.
Forever! Forever!
Estou errado. Quinto lugar foi Fontenelle. Onde está Fontenelle?
Oh!
Sexto lugar.
I protest. Who judged?
Nada vale de hoje. Porque a briga começa toda de novo amanhã. E eu fui 16º. Gente, muito obrigado por todos vocês estar aqui, tá? E vamos para a briga amanhã, uma briga boa, e vamos ver quem ganha. Eu falei para eles que é difícil o americano ganhar aqui, porque Deus é brasileiro.
Okay.
Boa,
gente. Diet soda. This is Rodizio. They cut the meat right at the table. And they're going to keep coming with all different meat all night. Endlessly. Is that steak? Steak? Okay.
Yeah, I think it'll be around the table.
Oh. Yeah, no, they come with, there's, look, sausage.
When you do it, you turn it over.
It looks about the same.
You and your wife together, but then you got Obama with Chicago politics.
What a handsome family.
Oh, I lost it. Where did it go?
What is this?
Green tea. It's tea.
It's tea. Okay. And you just put the water in there?
Yeah.
That's just water.
Yeah.
Hot water. Okay.
Want to try?
No, no, no. I need to be up early so I can beat you tomorrow.
This we like.
Yeah, not me. Not when you're 63.
Now we
get the
twins.
Twins. And you have two children?
Just the twins.
Twins.
Oh, no.
How many children?
Five.
Okay.
Are you the mother? You're five?
Yeah, the mother, yeah.
Five.
No, the other. Only this two.
Oh, yeah, this two. Yeah, yeah. After that, done, right?
Then he builds model planes.
Yeah, no. No, it's...
Tony Soprano is. Who's Tony Soprano? You know Tony Soprano? You're looking at him. Who's Tony Soprano? Tell him in Portuguese I'm a criminal. They don't get it. Portuguese criminal, right. Now I'm going to show you a magic trick. I'm going to show you a magic trick tomorrow. How to get fifth place without earning it. I have no idea what he said. Now, you would think they'd be out of meat with all the stuff we ate.
Gotten one of those and gotten the picture you dying on one of.
See, if Paul Walker was here, he could be having this, but no. He stayed home to watch Dancing with the Stars. Poor Paul. Paul, I hope you enjoyed it. He missed out on some good meat, baby.
Woo-hoo. Doesn't like it.
Sunday morning. We wake up to a bit of rain, just a little bit, as we load the van.
Sim.
Fala com esse bizão aí, qualquer coisa, bicho, o que é? Você virou vereador da cidade? Eu viro a tua picape e falei, meu, o que é aquilo?
Não, é.
Esse tamanho, imagina o pai como é que... Não, não, Fredinho.
Pelo que eu sei, ele emprestou.
Não viu?
É, ele emprestou o açúcar só.
Imagina o tamanho da criança do papai.
Então, tá um negócio. Eu falei, pô, se ele é um campeão...
Não faz
pô. O cara chega aqui, voa daquele jeito, por ser um campeão... Ele não está com a avião dele. Foi isso que eu pensei. Eu falei, pô, ele não está com a avião dele, né? Eu falei, ah, não, ele não trouxe a avião. Eu falei, então.
O garoto comprou um P40. Desse tamanho aí. Tá lá, deixa lá, que tá tudo picado.
Aí o filho do mundo.
Os mais importantes estão aqui.
O mundo tá aqui. Cadê o menino? Não veio.
O Lanterninha chegou, acabou de chegar, o Lanterninha.
É? Cheguei.
35, mas, meu, eu botei 35 nele, eu não conseguia nem pensar em parar, o bichinho subia. Eu ia entrar no loop e ele...
Olha que benção!
Zizinho, você tem uma mão aí, né, Zizinho?
Buenos dias.
Is it going to be like yesterday, just one on each circle, or? 2, 4, 6. Well, if it stays like this all day, it'll be just fine. Yeah. Yeah, this could hurt, you know. Well, the rain has stopped and it looks like there's next to no air yet. The windsock is kind of dead, but a lot better than it was an hour ago. And they're getting ready to start the contest. The first official flight's going to be Dave Fitzgerald.
Of course. If it's a contest, I go first.
He's certainly the luckiest one here. Top banana.
Hey, Thomas. Thomas, to my head. Pega minha manete e leva no centro da...
Again?
Dois. Dois.
Yeah, oh, okay. Okay, pretty good. Yeah. As long as the wind... That's a good spot. Good spot.
It's got to feel like a fish out of the water, not knowing how to start these things.
I'd rather have Benet. Who needs to know anything when you have him around? This is what it's like to be a NASCAR driver.
Só um segundinho, Benê.
Hamilton. Vai, continua.
Todos prontos? David, on your lines, the
speaker. Oh.
Get your jacket?
Yeah.
Oy, well, good thing it wasn't your nose. Dangerous sport. Dave Fitzgerald, first official flight. Circle two. Yeah.
esquece, isso é para o ímpar. No mundo você tem.
David Fitzgerald, first official. Sunday morning. Getting some of Benet's flight. Benet and Dave Fitzgerald were the two top dogs, and they got the fly, the two first flights. I don't know how they picked the order, but doesn't really matter. They got the first two flights. Yeah, right now it's pretty decent. No rain. Just a slight breeze. Not even a breeze. Maybe even dead air. So we're going to call you the tree killer now. The Audubon Society is going to be on your case. Of course.
Excellent.
What a dumb question that is.
Everybody's concerned with that tree over there. I didn't expect to hit that over there.
Well, you hit Benet's jacket on startup.
Oh, yeah,
he wiped out
that's what the sound was.
That was his jacket. He chewed his jacket up.
Did it slice it?
Oh, good. Yeah. You could put your hand inside where a prop
hit it. That was the sound. The prop got your jacket.
Notice he isn't wearing his jacket now. What does that tell you?
Thank you for all your help.
Yes.
I know you're very busy.
He's the man.
He is the man.
I can see why they worship him in Brazil. They have monuments to him.
We have a new the man.
The man.
It used to be Billy Werewitch.
So. No. We got the Brazilian man.
Brazilian.
You want to start here or on the ground? Here. Take your time.
There you go.
This is
preciso mais. Um pouco mais de combustível aqui.
Tudo bem.
Gostaria de amor.
The one failing of Yatchenko's airplane is him to finger on me. I'd fix that right away, believe me. Well, they fly good, that's all that matters. As long as you have Benet around to do all this dirty work, it's like being a NASCAR driver. They don't stop by flipping them? Uh-oh.
Tá com o que pegou? O barra bem.
That starter sounded like it was on the end of its,
No, I heard it. I hope he's got brought the plug to plug it in on. That's the best thing. Another guy in there?
No, no, no. Rush, first official Sunday. He's got a motor run at least.
was a little on the lean side.
Yeah, yeah, I'd be one click out maybe. Yeah. You got some nice air here, just enough breeze. Yeah, over in that corner, it's crazy. Howard Rush, first official, Sunday morning. Well, we're hearing the parrots overhead. And you can hear them in the background. The parrots have been flying over for the last 10 minutes. He's got an Enya in here, an Enya 61. It was running a little lean yesterday. Other than that, it sounded like it was an okay, you know, for an ARF kind of setup. It's fine. Sounds fast.
Yeah, it does.
Sounds like it's going to be too fast. Going this morning to an outdoor flea market or something?
I'm not sure.
A craft market?
Kathy said she didn't have to be ready till 9:30.
Oh, that's... I know, Karen needed some sleep too. She's not used to being up late like this. Neither am I. But that meat made it worthwhile. 40 pounds of meat. Pretty neat. Pretty neat. Is it up in, well, we'll see if it's up inverted. He wanted me to help him trim some of this, but I only got to see it through the video camera. Okay, so he needs a little tab on the bottom of the wing. Yeah. And let's do it between rounds and see if he's really cool. Put on the turbulator, adjust the handle. Thank you. Where's Howard when we need him?
Stand right here. Which way did Wendy need to get us more up?
More up?
Shorten me up.
Okay.
I stopped it when I told him because we can hold a button low, right?
Look at this and tell me if you think this is the right amount.
You're right. Oh, that looks good.
So we're doing a little experiment between rounds. Howard has put on some turbulate. Is that what you call them?
Yeah.
Igor Bergman Berger Turger. Why am I thinking of that guy that does the puppets? That's not Igor Bergman.
That's going pretty hard.
Yeah. I knew it when he was taking off. I was, didn't I?
We were dead lean, yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly.
But you know what happens to guys that really are not familiar with it? They think, oh, it's a contest. I got to just get through it. It'll go soft on the overhead eight. And it never does. Yeah. It just goes lean. Yeah, this could be a little richer. On the flight I saw yesterday, it looked just one click lean from what I would have it, but it was a little break, had a little break to it and everything. It was nice. And maybe a little tab on the bottom of the outboard wing, and he'd be.
Let's go through the low judges here.
Did we fly on a low circle or a high circle?
No.
Or you can't tell yet. I guess you can't tell till it's over. Oh! How could it be going this lean and running out? Can't be running out of fuel. Exciting! Yeah, a little tab on the bottom of the outboard wing.
Vinay is missing.
Okay, we begin round two. Same flight order, but we're on the other circle with the other judges. Just getting ready for Ben A to come and fuel the plane up. He's been pitting, doing all the motor starts, and taking care of business for the three Americans that are here.
Ball State, but that's because you're at the Nats.
Huh?
Ball State.
Yeah.
My sister went to school there.
Oh, really?
Yeah. We got some birds that are checking out the action here. Look like pigeons. And some little black guys. Waiting for Benet to fire up Dave's second official flight. As the tension builds, Benet carefully regulates the fuel. He says, Dave Fitzgerald gets a lean run again. I saw him clicking a needle in about three clicks. I don't know what that was all about. You're not going to chase those birds, are you? Hey!
Thomas, me ajuda.
Doesn't work for me either. I try in English, try in Portuguese. No difference.
Cadê o Mauro? Eu preciso de alguém pra me ajudar, o Barrabino. Vê se acha eles aí, Bruno. Mauro deve estar no carro.
Os juízes estão prontos?
Aqui foi só o teste da sua coisa, né? Fica mais
tranquilo. Fala, Vini, aqui é o Real Verde.
Ele volta pra cá.
David's saying, I have no clue where the wind is. It looks like it's exactly wrong to me. What do you think? Wouldn't you want the judges up here? Yeah. Pull rank, you're the world champion. Get over there. Get them straightened out. It's definitely not where they're sitting.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go. Yes, yes, correct. See, when you're the world champion, you get away with that. If I asked them to move, they'd say, forget it about it. Yes, an amazing display of technology. He went to get another jacket so he can chew up his other jacket too. Hey, a Ferrari hat. Whoa. Look at this guy's got a Ferrari hat. I wonder if he has a real Ferrari. Look at this. Ask him if he has a real Ferrari.
One of the Mexican pit crews at the last World Championships has two Ferraris in his
car. Really?
Yeah. Yeah,
John Cafaro's got one.
I know. Bueno, Vanda.
Ready?
Yeah.
Bow to the obelisk. Oh, they got to bring the chairs over.
I opened it one quarter.
Okay.
I don't know if that's right or not.
And I opened it a quarter, and Howard opened it a quarter. Now it'll run out of fuel.
Maybe I'll open a quarter.
And don't tell him either.
Cadê o diretor de prova?
Ó, vamos começar, juízes.
Vamos lá.
World champion Dave Fitzgerald, second official. Thank you. I feel the sun coming out. Believe this? The beginning of the sun. Just breaking through the clouds. Some birds are flying through the pattern here. Just like back home. Pretty nice air right now, and Howard's up next. And just like before, Benet and David are flying at exactly the same time on opposite circles. Okay, next up, Howard Rush, second official. Howard's just bringing David's playing into the pits. We pit on this side and come off on this side. What happened?
7:30.
7:30? I knew Benet didn't know how to set a needle valve. Boy, he really wants to win this contest, doesn't he? Yes. David, I demand a lie detector. One of those Thomas Case lie detector tests.
Tranquilo, que você está dentro dos 3 minutos que eu te chamei ainda.
Okay. Eu fiz 95. I had 95 last flight. Now I put 9.
Yeah, okay, so good.
Put 6. Rush, second official. I think he had the high flight on the first round, but I'm not sure. We haven't been looking at the scores. Just too much fun hanging out here. The Yashchenko Shark.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm ready. Just gonna film Harrod's flight. I'm after Harrod, but I don't think we have anybody around that'll be available to video, but we'll find out. Howard Rush, second official on Sunday finals.
Então aqui é o Zoom, cara. Ele falou, vou ligar a máquina.
Eu vou fazer um mundo, vamos dançar. Vai cantando. Ô, Rogério.
Então, vou
quebra o avião.
Tá voando bem, hein, bicho?
Tá. Muito bem.
Aqui na câmera você tem uma visão melhor. Good. E ela desfocou. Fernandinho, ela desfocou, e agora?
Tem um manual.
Dá uma olhada aqui, puta, me desfocou. Ah,
é melhor que você tentar corrigir, de passar pra mim. Perde mais ainda.
Muito
foi
bom.
O melhor voo dos americanos.
É o Windy. Good flyer, the Windy.
Parece que não vai dar tempo. A folheta não foi tão boa.
Sol, sol. Good, Wendy. This is the greaser, okay. Okay, that's what you make Howard wipe the plane off. Because I fire four stroke, I don't have to wipe it off. See, there's advantages to four stroke. Somebody rode in on what looks like almost a brand new Suzuki. V-twin Super Sport. Now this is a bike they don't sell, as far as I know, they don't sell these in the United States anymore. It's not in the new product lineup. It's got the stock pipes, steel pipes. Carbon fiber levers. I mean, miles, it doesn't show the mileage. Side mounted shock. Nice looking bike. This is a motorcycle. You cannot buy this in the United States.
Why not?
Very nice motorcycle, but they make a different motorcycle.
Why can't you buy in the States?
That's a twin. In America, they sell the four-cylinder.
Which one's faster?
Oh, four-cylinder. This is a 1000. The four-cylinder is 1340.
Oh.
Beautiful bike, though. Beautiful.
There are many of these there.
Hayabusa?
No, it's a TL1000.
Okay. They don't make this in the United States.
Yeah, they do.
Well, the new one, 2009, they don't make it.
It's a 1990.
Oh, okay. That's beautiful. Nice.
Yes, that is.
Yeah. Nice.
Do they
sell big Suzukis in Brazil? Hayabusa and B-King?
Yes.
Yep, and then V-Max coming soon.
Yes,
V-Max.
Yes.
My friend has a V-Max already, $19,000.
Yes.
They're very expensive.
This one is $4,000.
Oh, wow.
And there are many there.
Beautiful. Yeah, it's a nice bike, rides nice.
Yes. It's
comfortable. Yeah, very nice.
I always buy parts at USA.
Oh, okay.
These I bought there. The last time I went to Brodax, I bought the tires.
Okay. I have a 1000 1982, and I made carbon fiber mufflers.
Oh, right.
And I made a carbon fiber seat, a fiberglass seat.
Oh, yeah.
But it's an old bike, it's an antique. This of course, antique. Is modern. Nice.
That's a good
yeah, and runs nice. No problems.
No problem. Good on time.
Yeah, yeah.
Very nice. Aqui tá do Léo, foi. Não é carbono, não.
Não. É imitação.
Você viu isso? Tem uma vitamina agora de cadu.
É. Tá
sujo.
Vou tirar uma foto.
The old V-Max was much smaller.
Yes, but it was not a good cycle.
No.
Good ride.
No, not a good laying on a corners,
yes.
But the new one is much different, and they rated 4.5. You could have this magazine, because I already read on a plane for 10 hours. I'm sick of it. I got to buy another one. I hope Brazil has a magazine like this. Same thing, you know?
Yes. Okay, thank you. That kind
and you send me some pictures of your bike. I'll send you pictures of my bike with
I'll
the seat.
You,
the all the things I have.
Ah, eu trouxe meu. I got a pen.
You got my email, right?
I don't know if I have.
I'll get your card.
Okay.
Now, after a half hour chatting with our friends with the motorcycles. Yes, Scotch tape is fine. Let's turn it upside down. Let's take it over here. We need to put a little trim tab on the bottom of the wing, tape the hinge lines, and run the motor slower, and it'd be perfect. David's going to fly Tucano now, so
yes,
when he's well, so. We could wait. There's no rush. We're not going to Brazil. Oh, we're in Brazil. This is a good model. Okay, so we taped the hinge lines, and we made a little trim tab out of a soda can. Ah, we put it on the wrong side of the wing. Hey, the bottom. Oh, I did that. Ah. Oh, I know. Americans. I'll change it.
Here's Windy trying the Raul Estrega with the Enea 61 CX. This guy can fly a Estrega. What do you guys think?
Well, maybe we should go a little bit further here.
Here's Windy flying the Strega in Brazil, São Paulo. Andy, I think you really know how to fly this plane, don't you? Good cornering, huh? Well, let's get closer now. See, everybody's just watching him fly. Right on time. Now Raul is gonna fly after Windy has done some changes.
Oh, we just missed the Dynajet. He flew the Dynajet. Now he's going to have to fly it again because we missed it. Dan Banjak of Brazil. Is he going to fly again? Again? Benet got the fly to trim stuff that I did. We're working on a Strega. We're going to get another flight. I took out some nose weight. Howard and David both suggested that we get a big trim tab on the bottom of the wing. You know what else? I think he's going to fly the jet again. Maybe. We're just waiting for the Strega to come back to life. Huh? Yes. That's good. Just sleep. We could take some off now if it's too much. We try it just like this and then we'll make a decision. Okay, I get to fly it this time? And gas goes up in price, so they just use soda. Banjak, eat your heart out.
Joga, já foi numa vez, né, meu?
Here Windy goes again with the Strega. Perhaps something got loose inside the engine. Soltou alguma coisa lá dentro. Something dirt or something happened to the fuel line.
Muito obrigado para eles. Muito obrigado.
Parabéns.
Presença, agradeço o seu envolvimento e foi maravilhoso. Agora vamos chegar ao final. O final é quem ganhou?
O primeiro é o Thomas, uma salva de palmas para o Thomas também. Pô.
Rutsi Carvalho. Cadê o Rutsi?
Rodão, cadê o Rodão? Foi justificar o voto.
Foi votar.
O filho dele tá aí. Ah, tá aqui. Ó.
Tá aí o representante. É o filho. Tá aí.
Parabéns.
Em 17º lugar, Leandro Jardim.
Cadê o Leandro?
Oi, Leandro! Eu não sei como que você conseguiu fazer essa.
Eu também.
Por quê? Faz 4 anos que não voa.
Obrigado, cara. Parabéns pelo evento, cara. É muito orgulhoso de ter proporcionado isso pra gente. Obrigado. Valeu. É isso. Valeu, obrigado.
Hey!
Ele é avião.
Décimo quinto lugar, Luiz Belo. Eu estava em 14º. Melhorar um pouco.
Alguém que saiba fazer avião,
treinador, Décimo terceiro lugar, Osni Renato.
Muito
obrigado. Décimo primeiro, o grande amigo Celso de Silo, onde está? Mas a Milton Magri não deixou ele. Então, Wendy Ortonowski.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Who got fifth? I'll switch.
O campeão do mundo, David Fitzgerald.
Hey! Hey!
That's globalization.
Well, segundo lugar, Vene Rodriguez.
Hey!
Em primeiro lugar, o grande campeão do evento, o americano Howard Rush.
Hey, Howard! Woo!
Congratulations. Muito bem, gente. Muito obrigado a todos vocês. E agora vamos voltar.
Muito bem.
Obrigado, pessoal.
Hey!
Vai ter uma prova de acrobacia americana.
Primeira.
18 e 19 de outubro, Limeira.
Limeira!
Estaremos lá.
E eu vou junto!
Congratulations, my boy.
Thank you, sir.
Good show. Oh, my sunscreen. Okay.
Put this in there. Oh, we got bananas in there. And
does this mean we can't fly anymore, or we're going for lunch? Or?
No, you can fly. Hey, congratulations.
Hey!
Now, unless you were thinking this whole week is going to be about model planes and trophies and whatever, well, it turned out to be a whole lot more. Now that the contest was over, and let me give you a little sneak peek what's coming on the next two tapes. We've got some really, I think, things that blew me away. Little sneak peek just to pique your interest. And then we're going to get back to, well, on the next tape, we're going to get back to, we had some fun flying at the end of this. And we had some of the adventures that I don't even want to tell you. It'll be a surprise. But here's a little sneak peek of what's coming.
Thank you.
the motto of this trip has been, every time we see something, I think to myself, this is going to be a hard act to follow. And then about 2 hours later, it's followed. And this is amazing. And Howard and I are trying to figure out how they got it up here, how they made it. Of course, you can't tell, but it looks like it's, if you look real close, it's covered in some kind of tile, like mosaic tile.
Yeah. Okay. Another
time. That's enormous. Unbelievable. You can see here's an average sized person. This will definitely be a difficult act to follow. 11 million people, Rio de Janeiro, and Howard and I can't figure out how they made
Corcovado.
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 Corcovado. Not only how they made it, how'd they get it up here, and how did they keep it from falling over? Karen Corcovado. Karen and Kathy Corcovado. Here's where you would get the helicopter to go to. Right here is the helicopter ride, which it doesn't look like they're operating today for obvious reasons. Hey, hello. Hello. You could be on a windy video if you're not good, or if you're good. You better watch Karen, he likes blondes. Look at that hair. I wonder if he bleaches his hair. Do you bleach your hair?
One more with the baby.
Oh, there's a one with a baby. Yeah. Look at this. Look at this. He's got a baby. Oh, she's got a baby. Look at this. Oh, my God. Benet's got all the tricks to. There's a baby, sure. This guy's eyeballing Fitzgerald up. Says, oh, I'd like to have a piece of one of those ears. Isn't that cool? Now, they live in locally in a city, too?
Yes.
And how do they get up here? Somebody brought one up here, right? Somebody brought me to this mountain. What's going on here? At least there's plenty of food here.
Look at that hairdo.
Yeah, he looks like somebody I know, Karen. Look at a hairdo. I don't believe it. There's two babies on this one. He caught a butterfly in flight. No wonder they live up here. Look at this. They're running up the trees. You wonder they don't fall. Look at this. If this guy slipped,
our 8-year-old boy climbs up there. He doesn't fall either.
Yeah, you. I'll tell you what. Tightrope walk on that wire, dance. Let me know how it is down the bottom of the mountain. That's a great photo right there. If I could get this photo.